Cakewalk is the first dance created by the blacks, which was accepted by the white society as their own ballroom dance. It originated during the slavery time and was inspired by the quadrilles and grand marches danced by their masters. The blacks injected into it a spice of rhythm, a high style, and a surprise of improvisation. But it still was built on the mold of Caucasian posture and manner. The masters organized cakewalk contests for their black dancers, and whoever jumped the highest was the winner, and the prize was always a cake. That is why the dance was called the cakewalk.
Thank you.
Charleston in the 20s came as a shock, a complete revolution against the Caucasian grace and body unity. It shattered the body into separate limbs, swinging like a human mobile in a multiplicity of simultaneous but diverse rhythms. To analyze the structure of this dance, we present the abstract design of lights, which are light bulbs attached to hands and feet of dancers. There is a section filmed in double time to emphasize the regularity of syncopation, almost a mechanical precision. The slow motion reveals classical position of Charleston dancer, his body almost parallel to the floor. The drummer, Zuti Singleton, is the heartbeat of Charleston in his polyrhythms of flying drumsticks, arms, head, and torso. The dancers are of the generation who created Charleston. Each has his individual style. Thank you. jazz steps were created in the late 20s and the 30s. Along with Charleston, they revolutionized the Caucasian dance culture. They brought an undulation of the torso, a ripple of individual limbs, like in boogie woogie, shimmy, snake hips, black bottom, fishtail, mess around boogie, tracking, or Susie Q, etc. The most profound, the most essential expression of jazz. It was the American folk statement by the blacks about their lives here, a talking to themselves. Blues can be considered a cornerstone of jazz music. But blues dance never became an important ballroom dance. It was a couple dance of close embrace, very slow, almost stationary. The undulation was done on the inside, from body to body. It could be called a grind. The dancers in this sequence create moods and character pictures of blues. The motions which are born out of this music are decidedly of an African heritage, but the dancers were not aware of it.
Thank you.
Savoy routines were created by the famous Whitey. He started as a bouncer in the Savoy Ballroom, but soon proved himself a talented organizer and choreographer. He assembled a group of outstanding dancers, adapted their individual inventions and styles, added to it his theatrical know-how, and trained them with the discipline of a ballet master. But he always retained the spontaneity and improvisation so essential in jazz dance.
The dipsy-doo's a thing to beware. The dipsy-doo will get in your hair. And if it gets you, it couldn't be worse. The things you say will come out in reverse. Like you love I and me love you. That's the way the dipsy-doo works. The dipsy-doo is easy to find. It's almost always in the back of your mind. You never know it until it's too late. And then you're in such a terrible state. Like the moon jumps over the cowhead's hill. That's the way the dipsy-doo works. When you think that you're crazy, you're the victim of a dipsy-doo. But it's not your mind that's hazy. It's your tongue that is fault, not your noodles. Pretty doot, pretty doot, pretty little noodles. See, you hit you, dance a doodle. Dip, 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 doodle. You think you're crazy, the things that you say. Like rhythm got I and how's am I. That's the way the dipsy doodle works. Thank you.
calypso and applejack are a glimpse into a post-war style improvised by the new dancers of the post-war era. This concludes our survey of jazz dance forms from 1900 to 1950s.
Thank you.
dipsy-doo's a thing to beware. The dipsy-doo will get in your hair.